Hello everyone, welcome back to the lecture series of constraint optimization problem. Till now we have seen what are the necessary and sufficient KKT optimal condition to solve any inequality constraint optimization problem. Okay, there we have seen that with KKT condition there is a sufficient condition which says that if f and g1 are convex function, then the x bar point be the local as well as global point. But now we doubt that the convexity assumption of f and g1 of the KKT conditions are not sufficient for a point x bar to be a local or global minimum. These conditions are convexity assumption of f and g1 for all I. They are sufficient condition. Without these condition we can't say that the point x1 bar to be a local minimum. For example, we have the problem. This is my minimization f equals to minus x2 subject to the condition x1 square plus x2 square less than equals to 4 and minus x1 square plus x2 less than equals to 0. So this is my first constraint. This is my second constraint, which is x1 square plus x2 square minus 4 less than equals to 0. This is x1 square minus plus x2 is less than equals to 0. Now first thing is we have to prove that this is a all of 3 are convex function or not. Okay, so since it's a linear function, objective function is linear function, so it's a convex function. If you will see for delta g1, we have to find a Hessian matrix. Hessian matrix is delta square g1, which is, if you will find, it is 2 0 0 2. Okay, so first minor of order 1 is 2 and minor of order 2 is 4. Both are greater than 0. Hence this matrix, this Hessian matrix, is positive definite matrix, which means g1 is convex function. Okay, similarly if you will see for g2, my Hessian matrix is minus 2 0 0 0. So d1 primary minor principal minor of order 1 is minus 2, which is less than equals to 0. Principal minor of order 2, this is of order 1, order 2 is 0, which is equals to 0. So this is negative semi definite matrix. This you can see in definiteness of matrix lecture also, how to identify it is positive or negative definite or positive semi definite or negative semi definite. Now since it's a negative semi definite, so g2 is my concave function. Okay, which shows that this problem is not a convex programming problem. So sufficient conditions are not satisfied. But if you will see, first we will find the KKT conditions. First KKT condition is delta f x bar plus g1 x bar into lambda 1 plus lambda 2 g2 x bar is equals to 0. So put the value delta f, differentiation of fx is 0 and minus 1. For g1 it is 2x1 2x2. For g2 it is minus 2x1 1 is equals to 0 0. So from first element you will get a condition of 2x1 lambda 1 plus lambda 2 minus x 1 is equals to 0. And second condition is, this is first, second condition is minus 1 plus lambda 1 2 x 2 plus lambda 2 is equals to 0. So these are two conditions. Next conditions are, if you will see, second condition is lambda I bar g I x is equals to 0, that is lambda 1 g 1 square plus lambda 2 square minus 4 is equals to 0, and lambda 2 x 1 square plus x 2 is equals to 0. Third is your feasibility condition, which says that x1 square plus x2 square minus 4 is less than equals to 0, and x1 square minus plus x2 is less than equals to 0. Fourth is non-negative condition, that both the multipliers are greater than 0. So these four are the KKT condition. Okay, now this point 0,0 satisfy KKT condition. If you will check here, if you will put 0,0 on both the side, it's satisfied. If you put x2 is equals to 0, this will give you lambda 2 equals to 1. If you put here, you will get lambda 1 is equals to 0. From here, lambda 2 is equals to 0. This is satisfied. 0,0 minus 4 is less than 0. 0,0 is equals to 0. Lambda 1 is 0 or 1. Okay, so both are satisfied that it is greater than 0. Okay, so this point is satisfying all the KKT condition. But still, 0,0 is not the point of local or global minimum point. Why? This we can see graphically. Okay, so we will draw a graph for it. Suppose I will draw it here. Okay, so the graph, if you will see, once I will just clear it a little bit. Okay, you will see it graphically. So first we will see there are two constraint conditions. G1 is a circle of radius 2. Okay, so this is a constraint graph, G1 graph. Okay, G1 graph. And since, if you will see, you will take origin 0,0. If you put 0,0 is less than 4, so inside the circle is my feasible region. Okay, similarly with the help of second constraint equation, which is a parabola of x1 square, it will be something like passing through origin. Okay, it's passing through origin. And if you will see again, this point, this is 2,0. If you put 2 here, it's minus 4 plus 0. Minus 4 is less than 0, so this region below the parabola is feasible region. So common feasible region in this graph is inside the circle and below the parabola. Okay, so here 0,0 satisfy all the KKT conditions, but global minimum point, it is not a global minimum point, because, and since feasible region is not a convex set, because this is not a convex programming problem, that is clear. And if you take point 0,0, it satisfy KKT conditions, but it is not a global minimum point, because you can see that you have a minimization of minus x2, or maximization of, if you will see, maximization of x2, and x2 is a maximum at these points. If you will see, x2 is maximum at these points. So this point can't be minimum global point of this problem. So why it is not a global minimum? Because the convex minimum condition, convex is the minimum condition, is not satisfied. So why I want to say KKT conditions holds at a point, it doesn't mean that the point is a global minimum. Because of that point to be global minimum beside KKT condition, convexity of f and g I is required. So that is all clear by this lecture, that any point to be minimum or global minimum point, the convexity conditions are very important to be satisfied with KKD conditions. Okay, so that's all for today's lecture. Thank you.